Next up, we have Anurag from Intel talking about testing wearable devices.
Good afternoon, everybody. I am Anurag. I work for Intel. I work for a team called Test Enablers. We focus on all kind of functional and non-functional automation on mobile products. So now, today I'm here to speak on automation on wearable devices, smartwatches. Thank you, Google, for the selection. And as we all know, with the rise of the technology, of this wearable technology in both business and personal use, all the companies which have a solid space in the Android or iOS world have switched their focus to this wearable technologies and have developed their apps or support for this smartwatches. So this increases the effort of testing on those devices. Hence, automation comes into picture to reduce the effort and increase efficiency. Now let's see. So basically, the smartwatches, they're kind of three kinds of scenario or connections. One would be on an actual device and on an actual wearable or a smartwatch. The second scenario would be actual real device and an emulator, Android Wear emulator. And third would be both the things would be emulator. So now let's see how we can establish debugging sessions with the smartwatches and the phones so that we can start writing our test scripts and do the automation. Let's go to the first scenario. Here is the device where both the things are the real devices and the real emulator. So for this, what we need to do, first we need to have a device of Android 4.4.2 and above, which supports Android Wear. We need to install the Android Wear application on that. Then we enable Bluetooth debugging on the Android Wear app and as well as on the wearables. Then we connect the wearable device to the phone using the Android Wear app. After we do the connection, we open up command prompt and run this following command. Okay, so this is a port forwarding command which will allow the Android Wear device to list up in the Samsung list up in the ADB devices list. Once we do that, in the Android Wear app, if you go to the settings, there are two things, host connected and target connected. So both the status of this host and target should be connected, or else the Android watch or the smartwatch doesn't show up in the ADB devices list. So then we can see here, once this is done, you can see the top one is the smartphone, and the second one, localhost 4.4, is the device or the smartwatch device. So once we get the context of this, then we can able to write any automation scripts or your automation code on these watches. Now the second thing is the actual device and the wear emulator. This is my favorite thing for doing the automation because this is pretty stable. So now here, what we do, first we create an emulator device for an Android Wear, as shown in the image. So as we see here, we need to select the device and as Android Wear. There are different kind of sizes available for the target, but you can select any of them. Then you need to select the target API 21 or above. Then your Android Wear smartwatch emulator is ready. Then you go to the command prompt again and do a port forwarding again. So you run this command. Then your smartwatch would show up in the Android list, Android devices list. And then you have to go to the Android Wear app on the device, and you need to just click on, select the option, connect to emulator instead of connect to device option. Now you see here, this is for our application, we get this thing connected. Now the third scenario is device emulator and the Wear emulator. Here, as you see the arrows here, this is the problem which I face, which has only a one-way communication, which means the notifications from the device emulator would appear on the wear, but not the vice versa. For an example, if you have an app which is doing something, which you can send a command from your watch to the device, that scenario, I was not able to test it due to some limitations. That command doesn't go from the watch to the wear. So anyway, we need to see how we can connect it. Here, we need to create an emulator. Here, to note that we need to create a Google API image. While creating the device emulator, we need to select the Google API image. As shown here, not the Google image, which this has the support for this wearable devices. Then we create a smartwatch emulator. Then we need to connect to the telnet port of the device, and we need to do a port redirection again. So as you see, we can run this commands here and do the port redirection. Once you get the status OK, then you can get this emulator connected. Now we are good to go for automation. But the problem would be only the features, one-way features can be tested. Now the second, now we have the context of the watches on our code. Then we can start writing our automation thing. You can use any tool, but here the example is with the APM. So here, APM on multiple devices at the same time, if you want to execute or write a test case, you need to have multiple sessions, which each session is tied to a particular device. And while starting each session of the server, you need to mention the override option as true so that it can use the existing session instead of creating a new session every time. Then this is a code snippet where you start the APM servers for the different port numbers for both the devices. Here is a pseudocode to get the driver. One, this driver is for the smartphone. And here is the driver for the smartwatch. So here you see we have to give the parameters as the device name with the device IDs of the smartwatch. And here is the device ID of the wearable. Then here, once we get this drivers, we can write our clicks, drags, drops, anything you want. So this is a kind of framework what we have for our automation part. Here we have the APM thing sitting, which all the sessions of the servers are connected. And we have the smartwatches or the emulators connected to the phones. And here's the driver, which runs our all the automation. So here is a video which shows two automation execution of two features. One is from the phone, there is a notification. The smartwatch, there is a command which will go to the phone. And you execute some steps on the phone. Then again, we install one malicious application on the phone, and we get the notification on the watch. And we can open that particular notification on the phone itself. And you see the notification has been opened on the phone. So this is a both-way communication from device to the smartwatch and smartwatch to the device. Yes. Few things to the problem areas what we faced. First problem area is when we have an actual device and an actual wearable. Once we establish this USB debugging, Bluetooth debugging session, so on the smartwatch, there is a sticky notification which appears Bluetooth debugging enabled, which doesn't go off. It's always stay in the screen. So when we want to test the actual notification, which should pop up on the smartwatch, as it is a critical notification from the phone. So that always lies beneath the Bluetooth notification, debugging Bluetooth notification. So you need to either flick it or do something to see the next one. It appears, but you will not be able to test the scenario that it should always pop up on any other notification, as it's a system notification. That is one of the issue. The other issue, as I said, is with emulator. When both are emulators, this one-way communication happens. These are the two issues which is currently we have. But the actual device and the real at the emulator where is the best one till now. Yeah. So that's it from my side. Yeah. Can I have some questions, everyone?
Thank you. So do you have a similar solution for iOS devices?
This is from past 3 months when we started with this Android thing. So iOS, probably we should be able to do that, but we haven't deep dived into the iOS stuff yet. iOS smartwatches, because it's very costly to get it for testing.
How did you test the Intel Edison?
We don't test Intel Edition. First of all, I don't know what Intel Edition is. I test on this product called McAfee Mobile Security, which we have. In the last release, we had this wearable feature coming into picture, like whatever notification we have, like virus notification, or if there is an Wi-Fi attack on your connected network to your phone, you get all those alerts on the devices. So we started testing the automation of that, because this is a really big feature to do that, and automation was really helping.
Why did you use Appium instead of UI Automator?
This is, I said, we can use any tool. This is Appium, it's just a pseudocode, like how we can use the automation here for Android devices. The main thing was here, how to get the context and how to establish the USB debugging session. Once that is done, any tool you can use to do that. It's not APM or anything you can use. So that's the main thing, is once it gets listed in the debugging session, USB debugging or Bluetooth debugging session.
Is the use of emulators slow?
Yes. I had the same question, I think, to the Uber team there. They suggested like they're really slow, but some Geony or some new thing, but which is really Geony Motion, but it's really paid again. But yeah, the emulators are really slow. That too with the Google API image for a thing, it's again very slow than the actual one.
Great. Somebody's asking, isn't testing notifications on a smartwatch the same as testing the smartwatch itself?
No. Here, we are testing the features of the application, which has to appear on the watch. It may happen that the watch is working perfectly fine, but your notification doesn't appear on the phone. Or we had that kind of thing in our list release, and before our release, we found that kind of thing where the notification was not appearing on the phone.
And that is all the questions for you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.